What is the symbolism of the sukkah? I've discussed this before in many different ways. I believe I've come to a newer understanding. On the one hand, the sukkah represents for the Jewish people the hut. The hut that was put together very quickly and very primitively as a source of some kind of protection during their 40 years of desert wanderings. And the message of the sukkah is that exile will be a very important part of Jewish history. We know this from Hazinu. We know this from all of the prophecies within the Torah. We know this from our historical experiences. And God will protect us despite our wanderings and our exiles. That's the sukkah. The second thing of the sukkah, Anane Kavod, clouds of glory. But clouds of glory covered the Mishkan, the initial sanctuary. And the Vilna Gaon explains that the Mishkan, the sanctuary, was built 5 days after Yom Kippur. And that sanctuary was a portable Beit HaMikdash, which the Jews carried with them throughout their exiles. But the Mishkan, or the Sukkah, is then not a protective, physically protective hut, but it is the source of Jewish spirituality. God spoke to Moses in the Mishkan. God's Torah was given to Moses in the Mishkan. And the Mishkan is really a mini Beit HaMikdash. And the Sukkah is a mini Beit HaMikdash. And we took it wherever we went. And it ultimately finds its ultimate resting place, obviously, in the Beit HaMikdash in Yerushalayim, the city of peace, and the city from which redemption will come to the entire world. We usually think of the sukkah as the protective hut. But on Birkat HaMazon for Sukkot, we say in the Harachamans, that God should restore for us Sukkat David Hanofalet, the fallen Sukkah of King David, which was the Beit HaMikdash, which fell at the destruction of the temple. The Sukkah is a Beit HaMikdash. And that means that the major purpose of the Beit HaMikdash is v'naru elav kol ha'amim, that all the nations will come to it and they will learn from our ways and they will walk in our paths, and from the Beit HaMikdash the entire world will return to Judaism. And that is why the end days of Sukkot, Shmini Atzeret Simchat Torah, when the Torah was taken into the streets, and Ya'ari in his book on Simchat Torah says that there were customs throughout the Ashkenaz and Sephardi world to also invite the Gentiles to Simchat Torah, to dance in front of the Torah. because the Sukkah is the Torah that will be the Torah of the world at the time of the redemption. And these are two beautiful ideas. Protection in Galut and the Torah that will ultimately give its message to all of humanity and redeem the world. The Beit HaMikdash. So what is it? Which do we prefer? I dare say it depends where you live. If unfortunately you are still in Galut, have not heard the call of God and Israel to Israel, then it's the protective hut that preserved us despite our exiles. If you're fortunate enough to live in Israel, then it's the Sukkot David Hanofalet, which represents the risen tabernacle, temple, house of God for Israel and for all nations at a time of peace. May everyone come to Israel very soon, and may all of our Sukkot be Sukkot of redemption. Chag Sameach.